Business is hard. We've all got problems. This is my biggest problem this week. All right, guys, before we get into it, you know the drill. Like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you get notifications of new videos that are coming your way. Also, the other thing I wanted to mention is, so I'm starting on a new YouTube channel. You know, this has been all about business, helping others, trying to put information out there that will make other people's businesses easier, more successful, things like that. That's really what I want to try to do. Put the bad things out that happen in ours to try to make others' businesses more successful. So the other thing I want to mention is I'm making a new YouTube channel, not just me and the wife, me and the family. And it's going to be more focused on having fun, the things we do as hobbies, things of the family together, dirt bikes, more dirt bikes, you know, just different things in general. Maybe some day in the life, just normal like vlog stuff that's like not really business related. So I'm going to put the link right up here. Go check that thing out. Hit a thumbs up on the one video I've got. Another video is probably going to post in a day or so, and give the channel some subs. So let's get right into it. The biggest problem this week is poor communication in the office and poor communication in general. You know, I'm somebody that I've realized and I know, especially this week, I had a realization at Service Autopilot Conference about myself that, you know, I give people a million things to do. I give them a million ideas. Like my brain is always exploding with new ideas that I want to try and I want to do, and I can't do all of them. And if I deem them easy enough or capable of someone else, I'm pushing it on down the line. But the biggest problem I've realized is I do this with everyone, and I don't tell them A, what's the priority? B, what's the timeline? C, like I don't give them the tools to track and to make sure that's happening, or for us to all hold each other accountable. I just noticed over the last week that, you know, this is happening all the time. I looked at how I've been doing this, and I related it to things that just happened in the office. But I know this is happening in the field as well and everywhere. And I was in a class where they talked about, you know, effective communication in an office, some of the other tools to use, some of the other things to do to keep you on point. And someone might be watching this video right now being like, hey, I don't have many people in the office. Hey, I don't have many employees. But this is crucial to start off on the ground floor, becoming effective, using your ideas and making them effective, you know, when you push them out there. So really, like, the sum of this is I've realized that we don't get as much done. We don't have as much opportunity to get as much done as we could, because probably a lot of it because of me. So I realized I'm making the team less effective. We could be getting more done. And this is such a big deal, because right now I've watched this. I saw some of the things we should be doing. I want to use this across the whole team to make us more effective, because I know, you know, this year when we hit spring, getting 50, 60, 70 calls, you know, a week of new on incoming service, plus all the work you already have and all the upsells you're already doing, you know, it was insane. And I want to position us in the place to be able to take that on and grow accordingly with that. So that's really the takeaway, is I'm not that effective. I need to be more effective with the team. You know, I may be able to be pretty effective when I'm doing my own thing, but just my communication is poor. You know, my communication methods to lock this in and hold everybody accountable is poor. And looking at that and seeing that that's a huge problem this week all the time. Thank you, buddy. I'll be done in just a second. Could change our business, could change a lot of the things we do, could allow us to do more. And I know if you have that realization now, because you watch this video, that maybe I got one other guy helping me, but my communication is poor with him because he doesn't know the expectations. They're not cut and dry. He's going a million miles an hour. I do this, all three of these, to everybody. I'm a pusher. I'll run a million miles an hour, and I expect people to pick up the pieces and understand at the level I'm seeing them on what's important and what's not. So I'm going to change that in our business. I'm going to make our business better, and I challenge you to make your business better now that you've seen this. Guys, like, subscribe, hit that thumbs down button if you hated it, hit that thumbs up button if you loved it, and leave a comment. Share this with someone that could be helpful with as well. Like, maybe you're a guy working in the business And you realize, hey buddy, you realize that, dude, your boss is a maniac and he needs to work on this just like Jacob does. I'm a maniac. I need to work on this. You know, share this with that boss. They could use this as well. Guys, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and TikTok. My little boys are trying to walk into the screen right now. Here they are. Here's one. Blake. Hey, Jace, come over here. Hey, you're getting in the camera right now, wild man. Just so you know, this is a boy. He's got long hair, and he's cool. Jace, wave and say hi, everybody.
Hi.
Okay, so, you know, give us a... share this out. Follow me on those medians. And guys, I enjoyed shooting this for you. This is my biggest problem this week. I'll talk to you soon. Wave bye. Bye. Wave bye, JC. Everybody wants
bye.
To. Bye. All right. See you later, guys. Have a great weekend.